India gets first TIR shipment via Chabahar port. Where is the Chabahar port? This is in the Iran. Okay, developed by the India. So here, what is this? This is the first shipment under the United Nations Transports International Routiers, because this is in the French. Okay, Transport International Acts means this is international, and this is the routes. Okay, so this is arrived from Afghanistan, okay, through Iran port Chabahar to the India, okay, and it reached the Mumbai. So here the main important thing is, you know, we need to remember this. What is this? This is a transported international routes, which is a UN convention that allows goods to be sealed in a compartment and then require no need for a physical checking of the content. Okay, where is it is not needed? See, for example, what is happening? Afghanistan. From Afghanistan, you know, these goods are shipped onto a train or container, whatever it is. So it is, you know, entering to the Iran. So when it is entering, when it is crossing the border, then border checking will be there. That means they need to open everything and then they will check whether it is genuinely the goods or any other illegal items are sending. Okay. But, you know, under this agreement, if the containers are, you know, sealed and then, you know, the sticker is attached, which is saying that this is under the TIR, then you no need to, you know, open this and check again. Okay. They will check only the, you know, compartment and then they will pass this. Okay. That means here the custom clearance can take place at international custom locations. Okay, the custom clearance is only at the designated points, you know, custom locations. So that what happens, it will avoid the clearance at a border crossing points. Otherwise, if everything is needs to check at a border crossing, then it will take more time. Okay, and it may lead to often more congestion also because of that. So here, if you see the map, this is the Afghanistan. See here, officially we have a border with India. This is the border. India is having a border with Afghanistan officially. Okay, but only for the sake of our satisfaction, we always say. But in reality, you know, this is all belongs to the Pakistan here. POK, POK occupied Kashmir, that is what we will say. And they will say our Kashmir as the India occupied Kashmir. So here, only for the sake of, you know, politics, they are dragging all this. And always, instead of talking about the economy, they always blame the Pakistan for everything. And Pakistan politicians also blame India for everything, you know, instead of coexisting peacefully. So here, it will start from the Afghanistan, either through the rail or some truck, it will reach up to the Chabahar port, and from here what happened, by ships they will come and reach India. Okay, so see here, here it is a road transportation, and from here it is a, you know, sea transportation. That is, it is called as a multimodal transportation. And here, if you look at the Chabahar port, this is a very important point. Why? Because this route, you know, Suez Canal, through Suez Canal route is very busiest route. Okay. So, the movement under TIR can be allowed by checking only the seals and the external condition of the load compartment. Okay, once it is a seal under the TIR, then we'll see whether it is a, you know, seal is opened in between or not. If it is not open, then they don't check at the border. So, it will reduce the border delays. And transport and transaction cost also decreases, and thereby the competitiveness of the product will increase. Okay, so let's know about this TIR convention. It is the customs convention. Customs convention. Okay, custom means whenever some item is entering you from the other country, then you need to check the custom. On international transport of goods under the cover of TIR. Okay. And it comes under United Nations Economic Commission for Europe. Okay, and it will facilitate the seamless movement of goods within and among the parties to this convention. Okay, so for example, we are bringing from Afghanistan. That means Afghanistan also should join in that, and Iran also should join in this convention. Okay, to execute this. And at present, how many? There are 70 parties to this convention. Okay, and what are the benefits again? The fast, easy, reliable, hassle-free international system of movement of the goods, and it is either by road or multimodal means. Okay. See here in this case, from Afghanistan to India, it is a multimodal. And you might have heard, recently what happened, China sent, very huge amount of goods from all the way to China to something like France. Okay, it traveled through entire European countries. It is possible only because of this TIR convention. And imagine, see, instead of ship, if a train can reach from China to the France without much delay, then obviously it will revolutionize the trade and everything. Okay. So, of course, it will boost India's export and enable the greater participation in global value chain and improve the ease of doing business. Okay. Smoother transaction and safe transport of goods. And it can be reached to India, Central Asia, Europe, and Russia. Okay, so up to the Chabahar, it will go by the ship, and from there you can send by roadways. And digital platform to give single point access to exporters. Okay, see, whenever someone trying to export some goods to the other countries, then there is some procedure to be followed. Like what are the goods that they are sending and which countries they are sending. Okay, all these permissions and then everything should be informed to the government, and as well as the paperwork should be shown to the all other government whenever it is entering in the other country. Okay, so here they want to digitize this now. So it will be a single access point for all exporters. Okay, for all, especially for the all FTA and PTA. What is that? FTA, free trade agreement, and the PTA is a preferential trade agreement. That means, India or any other country, any other two, if two countries are entered in the FTA, what is the meaning of that? Free trade agreement means, there is a considerable reduction in the custom duty and tariff on the goods from other country. Okay, so here, whenever we are exporting some product to that, then they will utilize this digital platform. Okay, how is that happens? For example, certificate of origin. That means from which country these goods are coming. That is, a certificate of origin will be issued electronically, which can be in paperless format if agreed to by the partner countries. Okay, it's not only like our country. Yeah, other country also should agree for this. Okay, by mutual consent you can go for this. Okay, and one more thing is, like, authorities of the partner countries. For example, you are sending some goods to the Iran. Okay, and Iran can log into the website, and they can check the authenticity of the certificate from the website. Why? Because the website is an authenticated official website. From there they can check by entering the so and so serial number or whatever they have. Okay, and by that, it will avoid so many difficulties. And it also provides the administrative access to the Department of Commerce for reporting and monitoring the process. So here we will compare, like, what is the difference between these new platform and the existing platform. Okay, new platform, it is like a process is electronic and paperless and transparent. It requires the exporter to visit the agency at least thrice for each certificate. You need to roam around the office, and typical government office, everyone knows how to, they won't respond at all. And a real-time tracking of FTA utilization at a product level and a country level. And real-time tracking is possible, but here real-time tracking is not available. Why? Because it is not in the internet. It is everything on the papers. And here, electronic certificate of origin is issued here. Physical certificate, paper you need to carry always when you are going along with the product. And possible to electronically exchange the COO with the partner countries. Here we cannot exchange this, okay. And here it will reduce the transaction cost. Why? Because you don't need to go to the office. In the internet you apply everything, okay. And it will take more time. You need to go to office again and again to the government office. So here, what is the procedure? For example, if you are a regular exporter who is exporting a product to the other companies, then you go to the website and then register on the platform and apply for the certification of origin to any other designated agencies. Okay. And if you see here, India has 15 free trade agreements or preferential trade agreements with the various partners or countries. Okay. So whenever you have this, what happens? Indian exporters have a reduced import tariffs in the destination country. In order to avail this benefit, the exporter must provide a preferential COO in such cases. Okay. So, and next one is a Motor Vehicles Amendment Act. Here, it grabbed lot of attention, this year. Okay. Why? Because of the very hefty fines that are imposed on the traffic violations. Here, what is the main aim of this? The main aim of this is making Indian roads safer. How they make it safer? Okay, by strictly imposing the regulations. How it is imposed? By hefty penalties and reduce the corruption and use the technology to overhaul the country's transportation system. Okay, so the key facts I will quickly go through that. You just remember this. Okay, the law has proposed stiffer penalties for traffic rule violations. Okay, that became very viral, in those days. For overspeeding, dangerous driving under influence of alcohol and other offenses such as not wearing a helmet or driving without a license. Okay. And the new law also allows the center to ask manufacturer to recall vehicles in case of a defects that cause harm to the environment. Previously, it was not there, but now they included this. Okay. Previously, if if the center or any authority find the defects in the manufacturing of the vehicle, then automatically the vehicle itself will recall. Okay, if it is related to the safety of the passenger or the customer. But here, if it is causing harm to environment, in that case also the center can recall that vehicles. For example, now Bharat Stage 6 has been imposed. So if any vehicle which is introduced now after this date of implementation, then if government finds that it is not up to that mark, then they can recall those vehicles. Okay. The center, in consultation with the state, can frame a national transportation policy to transform the rural and public road transportation system and improve last mile connectivity. These are all vague words. And then here, the process of testing and certification of automobiles is proposed to be regulated more effectively. Okay. So, many times in European countries, what happens? They find out the false claims submitted by the automobile industries. For example, the emission, the amount of emission into the atmosphere, or the safety features, all these government agencies should test for every company, and they need to check whether their claims are correct or not. Okay. So now they need to make it more effectively. In India presently, we don't have that much efficient testing and certification authorities. Okay. And testing agencies issuing automobile approvals have also brought under this act. Previously, these were not under this. And driving training process has been strengthened. Okay. So that transport license you can give issue transport license, you know, very so many. Why? Because you know there is a large shortage of commercial drivers in the country, transport, especially for the transport vehicles. And to bring the harmony of the registration and the licensing process, it is proposed to create a national register for a driving license and a national register for a vehicle registration through Vahan and Sarathi platform. Okay, recently I logged into this and then checked my driving license and then vehicle number, but still it is not showing. Okay, it is still yet to implement this. It is taking a lot of time. They don't do immediately. And this has been already implemented in the Telangana, Andhra Pradesh. Okay, so its name is MRTA. So previously what happened, you need to physically carry always your driving license and then a registration certificate for your vehicle, but these days you don't need to carry. So you download this app and then you enter your phone number and then register in this, then automatically your driving license, your vehicle registration, everything will come up here, and you can show this to the traffic police. Here, the guardian or owner shall be deemed to be guilty in case of offences by the juveniles, and juveniles will also tried under the Juvenile Justice Act. This is very much important. Okay, why? Because many times you might have observed, you know, very chota kids, so they come with the scooters onto the road, you know, with a lot of speed, and most of the time they only make accidents. And in that case, these guardians or owners shall be guilty in such cases. Okay, previously it was absent. That is a very good step. And using the UE governance to deliver the services. Services means a registration process and then issuing the licenses. And enabling the online learning licenses, increasing the validity period for driving licenses, doing away with the requirement of educational qualification for the transport licenses are some of the features. Okay, presently they need to complete at least 10th class. Okay, but there is no logic for this. Okay, so they can reduce the educational qualification for that. And online learning license is very much important in giving this. These days what happened, when you are applying the learning license, what is the procedure? You need to go to the RTA. Okay, first you book a slot and then go to the RTA and they conduct some exam there. Some exam that is in Andhra Pradesh it is like out of 12 questions, if you can score six questions correct, then you will get the learning license. Okay, for that, why you need to go to the RTA? You can take that exam in the online also. Okay, you keep some time for something like 12 minutes for 12 questions, and you complete within 12 minutes your exam, then it will print. If you are passed, then it will print automatically the you are passed the learning license. Okay, like that they can do that. For that unnecessarily they are going all the way to RTA, and a lot of resources and effort is wasted. Okay, they can enable this online learning license in future. And one more thing is high security number plates and micro dots. Okay, so here the issuing of certificate of registration RC for all classes of motor has been blocked from 2nd May in the country for not integrating high security registration plates with the Vahan database. Okay, so what is the use of this? So, for example, if you have this high security number plate, then what happened? Theft can be reduced. How? Because it is easier to track the lost vehicle or a stolen vehicle. Okay. So, new amendment to the Central Motor Vehicles, is mandatory for all the vehicles. From sold after April 1st, 2019 to be fitted with the high security registration plates. We will see what are those. See, these high security registration plates numbers are made of aluminium and come with the reflective tapes. Okay, the plates are tamper proof. That means no one can alter this once it is printed. and equipped with a chromium based and a self-destructive hologram. Holograms will be there. Okay, even my vehicle got this chromium based and a self-destructive, which is a heart stamped on the plate. Okay. In addition, a sticker on the plate carries all the essential details, including the vehicle's engine, chassis number, and a laser branding branding of 10-digit you know, permanent identification number. For example, you know, if you read, if you go and read this hologram, then automatically it will show your chassis number, engine number, and everything. Okay. So, what is this chassis number and engine number? So, every vehicle comes with the chassis number and then the engine number. Okay, that is how they will identify the vehicle. Okay, that is why whenever you buy the RC, in on the RC you can see the chassis number, engine number, all these details are mentioned. So with the use of high security place throughout the country, the details about the car, engine, and chassis number will be stored in the national database. Okay, so this is how it looks like. This is the hologram. How this hologram is printed, you know, by using this very very micro dots. Okay, so what is this micro dot technology? It involves spraying the body or parts of the vehicles or any other machine with a microscopic dots, which give a unique identification. Okay, so what is the use of this technology? It will check the theft of vehicle and also use of fake spare parts. Okay, actually this micro dot technology will be, you know, given to each and every important part of the vehicle, and these micro dots and adhesive will become permanently fixture or a fixation which cannot be removed without damaging the part or the asset itself. Okay, so next one is International Center for Automotive Technology. Okay, so here, creation of new automotive test centers. Automotive test centers are very much important here. Why? Because what is happening, if you take any industry, as the industry evolves, what happened? Initially, in the initial stage, they concentrate on the features, only features. What is that? When the car cost is very high, or the affordability of a car in the Indian market is very very low in the initial days, then what happened these days, more and more people are affording that, and then so many cars are being sold here. Then what happened after that? Improving the feature is the main concern. The second stage is improving the main features, that means comfort. Okay, first is the features, and then luxury or comfort, and the next one is safety comes, you know, safety, and then safety means, you know, in terms of the accident safety, and as well as the environment also shouldn't be degraded because of this. Okay, that is why creation of new automobile testing center in the country under the National Automotive Testing and R&D Infrastructure Project is an important step. Okay, why? Because, you know, this is needed for the motor industry. Why? Because the regulations are becoming a tight and very tight day by day, and the technology is also changing in the, you know, automobile. So here, automotive electrical and electronics lab also established. Why electrical and electronics automotive? These days, you know, if you take the luxury cars, most of the luxury cars are having everything electronics, all the sensors and everything. Okay, and then electrical, these days, you know, electrical cars are replacing the traditional IC engines, and within 10 years everything will be electrical only. So the lab offers services for electrification and validation for a wide range of electrical and electronic components, okay, such as e-motors, ECUs, batteries, and this. So here, apart from that, tire test lab is provided service to the tire industry, vehicle manufacturing, and Bureau of Indian Standard. Okay, so why tire testing is very much important? If tire quality is not good, then when you are running at a high speed, if a tire is burst, then there is a fatal accident happen. And passive safety lab. Okay, in the passive safety lab, what is happening? It is dedicated to the support to automobile industry for their need to crash testing. Crash testing, okay. So different types of crash testing will be there. So head-on collision, two cars will come and then do head-on collision. So you need to see how much, what is the safety assured for the passenger inside, okay. So on the side collision, okay. And then this is also important these days. What is this? Pedestrian protection testing. Pedestrian protection testing, there is a survey like one third of the accidents are or one third of the car deaths are happening because of this pedestrian protection, pedestrian accident. Okay, when will happen, especially if you take the urban area or towns, then what is happening? Car is going relatively at a low speed in the city, and what happened in the city, all of a sudden, people will come when they are crossing the road. Then if you are unable to react quickly, then what happen? Or if you are distracted while driving, then there is a chance of accident, and then it will cause the death. In such cases, what is happening here, you can do one thing, two things. What is that? If a car is like this, then what can we do? You can make these pores and material soft so that even after impact, it may not cause that much of fatal injury for the, pedestrian, okay. Otherwise, this is not so possible. Then one more thing is with the advent of the technology, you can keep some sensor here. You keep sensors. So when you keep the sensors, what happens? As soon as it comes nearer to any person, then automatically it will override the driving mode and then halt the car. Okay. And the sled testing is one of the cheapest way to test the the safety of the car. Sled means they will take mud or heap of sand, and then a car will come with the speed and then dash this and see how it is impacting because of this, okay. And these are all for the sake of testing, and India need to establish all these facilities, okay, because these days more emphasis will be on the safety. So PSL has the state of art test facilities capability of conducting crash testing of vehicle health as per the Indian international regulations. Okay. And then next one is the Rail Development Authority. Okay, this is important. Why? Because what happened a few years ago? Previously there were two budget, on the first day they will introduce the railway budget, and then second day they will introduce the general budget. But in what happened, they merged these two budgets, so there is no separate railway budget. So whenever you want to raise the price of the rail ticket, then what happened? They can do only in the railway budget. Okay, but after merging, you no need to announce in the budget. Whenever you want, you can raise the prices of the rail. Okay, so for that purpose, you need some authority. That is why they developed this Railway Development Authority. They named it as a Railway Development Authority. So what is the main aim of this authority? The government has approved the setting up of a Railway Development Authority. Yes, the role or mandate of RDA is including provide expert advice to government to make a decision on pricing of services, commensurate with cost. Okay, when the cost is increasing, operating cost, then you need to raise the price of the railway tickets. Okay, and a measure of enhancement of non-fair revenues. What is this non-fair revenue? How to enhance the non-fair revenue? That is how they will mention. Okay, what is the non-fair revenue? Like advertisement in the railway stations. Okay, you give railway station space to the hotels or a restaurant. Okay, like that, or you develop the very big mall near to the railway station, because railways is having a lot of unused land. Okay. Even you can advertise on the back of the railway tickets also. So protection of consumer interest by ensuring quality of service and cost optimization. Service quality of service also should be increased in the rails and railway station, and promoting the competition, efficiency and economy. How you promote the competition? Okay, so recently they introduced the Tej Express. Okay, encouraging the market development and participation of stakeholders in the rail sector for ensuring fair deal of this will take a lot of time. Okay, railway is 100% owned by the government, so there are no stakeholders. Market development and participation stakeholders are in the railway sector. Okay, presently there are not much existing, but it is advising you need to encourage private people also. And creating positive environment for investment, these are all waypoints. Promoting efficient allocation of resources in the sector. And benchmarking of a service standard against international norm. This is important. Benchmarking of services standard. What is the meaning of that? If you look at some of the Japanese and European countries, what they do, if they announce if the train is 10 minutes or more than 10 minutes late, then they will return at least some percentage amount of your ticket cost. Okay. So that is the level of dedication they have. But whereas in India, some trains reach after 1 day late. Okay. No one cares here. And that is what, the level, they need to benchmark this service standards. And then enforce it. And provide a framework for a non-discriminatory open access to the dedicated freight corridor infrastructure and other in the future. Okay, this is also important. Where is this dedicated freight corridor? It is there. One is a eastern dedicated corridor and another one is a western dedicated freight corridor. But unfortunately, these are covering only the Mumbai to the Delhi and Delhi to the Kolkata. Okay, but they have not started the same dedicated corridor in the South India, connecting the Chennai, Bangalore and Hyderabad and Vijayawada, these regions. Okay, so government should come up with that also. And here, what is the point here? See, dedicated freight corridor, no discriminatory. For example, you establish a company there which is manufacturing the cars, and you need to utilize this dedicated freight corridor to transport your vehicles from one place to the other. Okay. So, BJP government and you supported something like a Congress, then they should not show any discrimination, to give slot to you on this. So, non-discriminatory open access to everyone on the dedicated corridor, it need to ensure that. And it also always suggests the new technology for to achieve the desired efficiency. And it also suggests the human resource development, regular training. And the next one is bullet resistant jackets made under Make in India initiative. Okay, so it is not a new thing, but what happened? See, previously when our army need bullet, army or police, what happened? They mentioned their specification or requirements. Okay, we want so and so like that, so you can you make it? Yes, so some tenders will come and they used to say that yes, we can make it. Otherwise, sometimes what happens? Army call for the army or police department or whoever want this, they call we want bullet resistance jacket. Then since what happened previously, since there is no prescribed standard, then whoever tender comes and then they give this, we can do. Okay, these are the features. Okay, these are the features we have, are the technical details we have, we can do this, we can do this item, we can this, I mean, it can be this much weight, and we can make only 1 kg or 2 kg weight jacket. It can
stop if bullet is fired from this much distance. If it is a close range, then it may not stop. Like that, they will give, and according to tender specification only, they can manufacture this jacket. That's what used to happen. Okay. So, but what happened now? The Bureau of Indian Standard recently specified some standards, like whenever you tell like a bullet resistant jacket, that means it should maintain this minimum requirements, okay? Then, you know, they need to pass at least these minimum requirements. That is what they did. So, the jackets have been made using the standard set by Bureau of Indian Standard. Previously, it was not like that. Okay, individually they used to mention, and because of this, what happened? India has now joined the select league of nations such as US, UK, and Germany to have its own standard for bullet resistant jackets. Okay, and because of that, what is happening? You know, see, because of this, you know, they fulfill the long pending demand for Indian armed forces, paramilitary forces under state police. Indian armed forces is army, paramilitary is under the Ministry of Home Affairs, central government, and state police. So, and one more thing is, we'll assist them, and then it is streamlining their procurement process and interoperable. Okay, previously what happened, if police force is not having that much funds, then they will go for the less specification, and army may go for the higher specification. But now everyone can go for the same specification, and it will be easy for everyone. And the jacket will be lightweight, between 5 kilos to the 10 kilos, depending on the threat level and RF, best quality in the world. Okay. So, and the jacket cost also less, 70,000 to 80,000. So, compared to the previous one, but still it is very costly. I think in future they may go down further. And one more thing is, they have dynamic weight distribution. What is the meaning of that? You know, based on the movement of the person who are wearing this, you know, the weight will distribute, you know, it won't cause any fatigue. Okay. And because of that, what happened? It feel like a half is the actual weight, and easy to open and release the system, and easy to, you know, wear and remove the jacket as per the requirement. And it also allows the jawans to use his weapons with ease while getting 360 degree protection from the bullet. Okay. And if you look at this, see, the main material used in this is Kevlar. Okay. Kevlar, we studied up the Kevlar in the polymers. Okay. So it is a type of a plastic or the polymer. So in the Kevlar is made like this, and see here, we have a Kevlar in between, red color one, and that is separated by a plastic film, and it is glued together, and it will be made like this. Okay. And then next one is a disease diagnostic kits. These days, these are very much important. Even Google also spending a lot of money to develop a very tiny and useful kits, medical kits. So mainly there are two types of kits developed. What is that? One is a blue tongue sandwich ELISA kit, and then another one is a Japanese encephalitis. Okay, Japanese encephalitis, what the hell. So this is very much important. We will talk about this. So for this is for the control of swine, and then detection of antigen. What are these? We will see. So the main characteristics of the two kits. The kit help to assess and act to infection of the Japanese encephalitis virus in the swine population. What is the swine here? Swine is a domesticated pig. Okay, it is a domesticated pig, and these kits are highly inexpensive as compared to the commercial kits that are available in the market. For example, presently it is 50,000, it became 5,000, you know, it drastically reduced this. So here we will see what is this Japanese encephalitis. Okay, see here, this initially it was recognized in the Tamil Nadu, and it was there in the South India only until in 1978 or something like that. And the first time they identified this is in the North India, and that time onwards, instead of outbreak in the South India, most of the time the outbreak is happening only in the North India, and especially Uttar Pradesh, eastern parts of Uttar Pradesh, eastern parts of Uttar Pradesh, and then some parts of the Bihar. Okay, so the main reason for this is flooding conditions and tropical conditions, and then farming, the places wherever the farming is prevalent, these places are more susceptible to these outbreak of these Japanese encephalitis. Okay, so what happens, this is a this disease comes in the pigs, domesticated pigs. First it will come in the domesticated pigs, and the pigs will be affected, and the human, whoever in contact with this pig, also contract this disease, and so many cases are reported and death also reported because of this. Even this year also it happened, it became a very big news. Okay, so what happened by using this kit? Whenever any swine or the domesticated pigs are showing symptoms, then it can assess this active infection of JE virus, and if it is more, then you can predict that the outbreak may happen in the human also. So based on that, you can move these pigs into the quarantines, like you can separate them from the human areas. Okay. And then blue tongue sandwich ELISA kit. What is the blue tongue? Blue tongue is a virus, is an insect transmitted viral disease of a domesticated wild ruminants. Ruminants means, you studied in the biology. Ruminants means the animals which are having this property, like they will eat from the plant, and then they will digest. For the digestion, they have some special arrangement inside the intestine. Okay, so those are called these ruminants, and then sheep, goat, cattle, or buffaloes, and camels are comes under this category, and especially the sheep will sheep are more affected under this blue tongue. So this is not transmitted to the human, but there is a loss of business for the people who are going for the sheep rearing or goat rearing. Okay, whenever there is a blue tongue, and generally the symptoms are like this, lot of headache, and then they will show some unusual pain in the behavior differently. Okay, by using this kit, blue tongue virus can be controlled under vaccination. You can identify that, and then you can go for the vaccination of the susceptible animals. And here, one more thing is transfer of technology by ISRO. Okay, so ISRO has transferred its indigenous technology to produce the space grade lithium ion cells to the BHER. Because of the lithium ion, this news become important. Okay, so now these days the lithium ion batteries are ruling the world, and they will rule further. Okay, within 10 years, everything will be replaced by the lithium ion. All this petrol, diesel, everything will be replaced by this lithium ion. Okay, so what happened in India? No company, if you observe, lithium ion battery, whatever batteries we are using, cell phones, all these cell phones, laptops, everything is using this lithium ion batteries. Okay, and no lithium ion battery presently is being produced in the India. Everything is imported from other countries, especially China is ruling the in this. Okay, India always, sometimes I am very much discontent with this government. No, they always worry about the temples or war with Pakistan or everything. But see, why can't they encourage these type of things? China, each and every, even homes also, they are able to prepare these batteries. That is why the manufacturing field increased a lot there in the China. So here, at least now, this Israel has given this technology to BHEL so that they can produce this, because other private companies, they don't have this technology. It is easy to produce, but other companies are not entering in this. I don't know what is these companies are doing, very, very big companies also. So here, they can produce and sell the lithium ion cells for meeting national and commercial applications, our national, okay? And then, they will totally modify the space grade, and then it will decrease the cost. Why? Because space is having much more efficient one. And BHEL is in the process of establishing the production facility near the Bangalore in Karnataka. Okay. And then, so we will study about the lithium ion. Why? Because now this is ruling the world. So what is the lithium ion battery? Or lithium ion battery is a type of rechargeable battery. So lithium ion battery are commonly used for portable electronics and electrical vehicles. Electrical vehicles means Tesla. As soon as I tell electrical vehicle, you should remember the Tesla. Tesla revolutionized the, the car industry because of this. And how the Tesla is manufacturing? Tesla is not directly manufacturing these things, okay? The Panasonic is one partner, and Chem China is another company that they are trying to tie up in the China. So in lithium ion, in this battery, what happened? Lithium ion move from the negative electrode through an electrolyte to the positive electrode. Okay, I will explain this through the diagrams. Okay, so why these are gaining the importance? Why these are gaining the importance, lithium ion? Why? Because they have high energy density. What is the high energy density? The batteries are very small, but still capable of producing more amount of current. Okay, that means it can produce the current for more time. What is the meaning of that? You might be using, your smartphone. These days, you are using the internet and you are using so many apps. Still, if you charge, fully 100%, then it will come full day. How it is able to come? Because of the high charge density. That means it is taking more current when you charge, so that it can come for more time. And no memory effect. And low self-discharge. What is the low self-discharge? That means, even if you are not using anything, automatically these batteries will lose their discharge. Okay, so these are having very, very low self-discharge. That is why they become very, very famous, lithium ion. And here we will quickly see the mechanism. Okay, why? Because they may ask this mechanism also sometimes. See, first I will talk with the charging mechanism. Charging mechanism. Charging means I am charging the battery. I bought the battery lithium ion and there is no charge in that. I need to charge it. Okay, so what I do is, I will connect this negative and positive terminal. Okay, this positive terminal is connected to the cathode and negative to the anode. And here, if you observe, these are the plates. These are the plates and, and the cathode plates, and in between, I kept, lithium. Lithium, actually lithium is not existing alone. That means, it will exist as a lithium oxides of lithium or lithium oxide. Okay, lithium oxide, because the single lithium is a lithium atom is a very unstable. Okay, it cannot exist alone. So it will come back and always form with the oxide. Okay, so here I kept these lithium oxide here in between these. Okay, otherwise I can say like this is lithium, in between these layers. Then what happened? When I'm trying to charge, what is happening? Because of this positive terminal, what is happening? Current will come. This is a positive, that means current is going in this direction. When current is going in this direction, that means electrons going in the opposite direction, okay? The current direction is opposite of the movement of the electrons. So here, because current came, what happened, it will disturb the lithium from the oxide. Then when lithium is disturbed from the oxide, then what happens? It will release the electron. When the electron is released, then because it is a positive terminal, then this electron will go in this direction. The electron will go in this direction and come to here. Actually, the electron can go in the outer circuit or inside also. Electron go inside also, electrolyte. Here we have one electrode here, which is called as cathode, another electrode anode, and these two electrodes are connected by the electrode here. Electrolyte. But we choose the electrolyte most of the time, solid electrolyte, in a such a way that it will prevent the passage of the electrons. It will prevent the passage of electrons. Because of that, it will choose the lesser resistant path. That this is the lesser resistant path. So it will go all the way from here to here, and then it will come here. The electrons come here. When the electron come here, and here what is happening? This lithium is lithium became Li plus, and this electrolyte in a such a way that it will allow the passage of the Li plus here. Lithium ions. And here, generally anode here, we will take the graphite rods as the anode here. So what happened? This lithium come here already. Electrons came here and then electrons came here and lithium come, it crosses this and come here. So both electrons and lithium again, combine together here. Like that, all the lithium, whatever we have, everything come here and stay here. Understood? Everything come here and stay here in the graphite. These are the graphite plates. What happened? This is a lithium, but whereas here it is a lithium oxide. Generally, lithium oxide is much more stable form than the lithium. So when I charge the battery, here this is a more of unstable form at the anode. Then what happened? I connected a load. Load means some motor or some bulb or whatever it is. Then when I connected here, then what happened? The circuit is closed. When circuit is closed, as soon as circuit is closed, what happened? The lithium here, what happened? It will again release the electron and it try to go back to its ground state. Here, this is the excited state at the anode. It want to go to the ground state. Why? The energy level should be less to be stable. It is something like that. Hill type, and you keep ball on the hill, then what happen? This ball is equivalent to this stage, unstable stage. Then as well as you release this, then it will try to reach the minimum ground position. In the same way, it wants to reach back here. How it is reaching back? In the process of reaching, what is happening? It will give up its electron here. It will give up its electron. Then electron cannot pass through the electrolyte here. Then it will go in this way. So electron is going in this way, then current is going in this way, opposite direction. So the lithium is coming back here, and again it is reacting with the electron, and then it is combining with the this lithium oxide, and it is in the stable format here. So here this is what happening in the lithium ion rechargeable battery here. So here this it is written as a separator. So generally here in a lithium ion battery, we will take the electrolyte, solid electrolyte like this. What happens sometimes? The solid electrolyte may evaporate if it is overheated. When it is evaporated, then the anode and the cathode may come together, and then short circuit will happen. Because of that, what happened? It may blast. Battery may blast. To avoid that, always there is a separator. Apart from the electrolyte, there is a separator here. So even if the electrolyte is evaporated, then these anode and cathode cannot come in contact with each other, so that there won't be any short circuit here. And there are some other properties related to this. No need to go that much detail. And one more thing you might be feeling like, when electrons are going this way, when electrons are released, they may come and touch here. the electrolyte. So that electrolyte will be damaged. Okay. So actually what happened when the first time when you charge the battery, okay, this when the electrolytes are when the lithium ions are passing through this electrolyte, then what happened? They will form some very very thin film on the surface of the electrolyte like this, thin surface. Because of this thin surface, even though electrons are coming and touching this electrolyte, they don't touch the actual material of the electrolyte, but this film will protect that. Okay, this is the accident discovery, and it is coming, it is a, you know, this came as a handy for them. Okay, so in case of Tesla, what is happening? The Tesla will take, very small batteries like this, very small batteries, lithium ion. They take so many batteries like this, very big pack of batteries, and they will connect everything in that series. Instead of taking very big lithium ion battery, they will take it very, very small. Why? Because here, the advantage is it will increase the efficiency, and based on the load, you can alter the amount of current needed. And when you need more power, when you are going cruising at the higher speed, then there is a load on the batteries. Okay, if it is very big battery, then it will become very tight. Why? Because everything is taken from only one battery. But if the big batteries consist of very very small batteries, then what happened? The load will be equally, distributed among all these small batteries. So compared to the, the tightness felt by this big battery, the tightness is shared with a different small batteries. Okay, so that is how they have taken this call, Tesla. That is how it become very famous, Tesla.